really beautiful. I like this a lot. We're here at Serenity Salt Cave and the Healing Center, and we're looking at their yoga class area. The studio not only does yoga, but it does special events, you said, right?
Yes, we do.
And we do some energy work in here. We also do the singing bowls, or they do the singing bowls. And tell us a little bit about yoga.
Yoga has been around for about 5,000 years. It is an enduring exercise. It not only deals with the muscles and the tendons and ligaments stretching and building those up, it also deals with the mind also and getting that, your whole core energy center.
So who would come to yoga? Is it just for women, just for men, just for kids? Do they do it the same? How does it benefit the different sexes?
We have various yoga classes that we teach here, from vinyasa flow to hatha to gentle yoga for the seniors that come here. We have a veterans program also that they get a yoga class, and we also get a thank you, Kelly. I'm sorry. A free salt cave event with that.
Very nice. So, do they have to be veterans that are just living in this area, or just anybody that's a veteran can come to? That's awesome.
No, it's veterans all over.
That's awesome. I like that. I like that a lot. So, what are some specialties that you do in the yoga class here?
As far as yoga?
Like, do the different instructors have different specialties? Or
we do. Each instructor has something that they personally design their class for. And people that join our studio pick the class that resonates with their energy and how they are, their abilities to perform.
Outstanding. Well, you've done a really good job here. I love the decor. I love the feeling. I love how you've got everything set up. I'm very pleased. I know you're really proud of this place.
I am proud of it. We wanted to make it simple, but yet serviceable.
Well, you did a good job. You did a really good job. Tell me about this that we're standing in front of right here. The singing bowls you were telling me about. How do you incorporate that in with the yoga?
Generally, as a rule, I play the bowls in Shavasana, which is the last pose, the most important pose of a yoga segment. It allows the body to continually build that core energy, but also in a relaxation mode.
Okay.
And the bowls help to resonate on that, and it helps them to relax even more.
Nice. Now, I haven't experienced these before, so I'm really looking forward to it, but why the different sizes?
The different sizes correlate to the different chakras of the system. And chakras are a vortex of energy that your body is stabilized on. You know, everybody is energy. Everything has a vibration. So the bowls are very important for that because it aligns the different chakras. And we can teach that later. But they're energy centers of the body.
Very good. Now, do you think that we could watch some of the poses they're going to be doing and talk to some of the instructors?
Oh, for sure.
Awesome.
Thank
you so much. This is awesome.
Thank you.
The benefits of chair are so many from head to toe. The fingers are receiving benefits as they're nice and straight. The elbows are engaged, which is activating the bicep-tricep muscles. And while you're here in chair, just notice your heartbeat. Connect with it. All the breath is guiding oxygen into the blood, making the body stronger. The knees bending is engaging all the muscles in the legs, the glutes even involved. We're going to now begin to straighten the knees, flowing back to the mountain, allowing the arms to rotate forward, shoulders remain pressing downward. Let's go ahead and do another flow back to chair. Inhale, arms turn inward. We begin to soften the knees, lowering the arms. All of the movements are guided by our breath, allowing us to connect with the rhythm of the heart. Nice. Let's go ahead and inhale, straightening back up to mountain. Mountain is actually my favorite posture, one of the simpler ones, but we get so many benefits from head to toe. From here, we can rotate arms in, your arms together, elbows come to bending, allowing the hands to stop at your heart center, shoulders press down, press your hands forward, straightening elbows, straightening arms, inhale the arms open, open heart and arms lower. Very nice. Well, I was told that all three of us were going to rotate teaching a pose, so I was teaching you all chair pose. Now I invite another instructor to come up, and we've got downward facing dog and child's pose.
Child pose is a resting pose, also called vilasana in Sanskrit. I do a lot of child pose in my sequences. I teach restorative yoga, and I teach restorative yoga here in the Salt Cave on Wednesdays at 10 a.m. and 7 a.m. And child pose is a beautiful pose, so I'm going to ask you all to come down to your knees. I'm going to turn sideways so I can talk you through it. Now there are two variations of child's pose. So first I want you to come to all fours, your back is neutral, and then I want you to gently push back onto your heels and see how that is feeling. So child's pose is you would slide your palms back, you would bring the tops of your hands down to the mat, and you would bend forward, bringing your forehead to the mat. If your body allows that, gently bring your arms back up underneath your shoulders and bring yourself to upright position, sitting back on your heels. And then I'll show you the another way to achieve this. So I would just ask you to walk your hands out in front, coming down, stretching your fingers wide, palms on the mat, bringing your forehead down. Now, if your tailbone's rising up, just let that happen. Just let that happen. And just bring your forehead to the mat, just resting, thinking about relaxing your shoulders. Child's pose is one of the poses that you would come into for relaxing, but it's good for many things, and I couldn't even begin to tell you what they all are. Digestion, comfort, broken heart, sad spirit, whatever's ailing you, child's pose can benefit you. If you'll come back up the hands and knees, let me show you another variation, extended. Bring your knees hip width, maybe a little wider than hip width. Bring your big toes together. And then sit back on your heels and gently walk your hands out. This time, letting your whole torso fall between your legs. Let your chest come to the mat, if that's available to you. Forehead to the mat. Thinking about relaxing through your shoulders, your arms, your head. Let your head be heavy on the mat. Breathing deep. Feeling the restriction of your breath here. Yoga actually means union of your mind and your body. So slide your palms back up, and then we didn't pass out props, but I'm going to show you this. This is a restorative pose that I do in almost every one of my sequences. It's called restorative child's or salamba balasana. So you would pull your you would get in the same position, knees spread a little wider than your hips. Pull your bolster in, and then then you would just gently bring your torso, your upper abdomen, your chest down onto the bolster. And then you would think about letting your shoulders just relax over the bolster, taking all the weight off your arms, just letting them be. Really feeling the restriction of your breath in the chest, noticing how your back rises up. In restorative as well as all yoga, we seek to connect our mind and body. In this culture that we live in the West, where it's go, 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 peek, 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 and more, 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 we want very much to bring it all back to right here. Right here, really, right here in your heart. And that you would live from your heart, and that you would respond from your heart, and that your mind would always be in subjection. That's my goal, anyway, in my classes, and for my own life. Sarah shares a little bit of her childhood experience with yoga, because she's been practicing it a very long time.
We did Kundalini yoga, which is a lot of linking kriyas, which are movements, with breath. And so now I like to teach vinyasa flow, which is very similar with the linking of the movement and the breath. So one of the postures that we do often when we're doing a flow class is downward facing dog. And this is considered a resting pose, which some people would not agree with because it can be a little bit more difficult. But I'll go ahead and walk you through it. So coming to table pose, your wrists are underneath your shoulders, your knees are underneath the hips. And we'll go ahead and do a couple cat-cows, just loosening up the spine again. Inhaling as you bring your gaze up towards the sky, shoulders back. Exhale, rounding the spine, bringing the chin in towards the chest. Do it one more time, inhale, looking up towards the ceiling. Exhale, curving the spine, bringing the chin in towards the chest. Coming back to your table, go ahead and curl your toes under. You're going to press into the hands, bringing the hips up and back. If your heels do not touch the ground, that's perfectly fine. And you want to think about pressing into the knuckles of your fingertips and your thumb. Go ahead and bend your knees a little bit and really try to focus on lengthening the torso. So from your wrists all the way to back, feeling your chest going towards your upper thighs. And you can go ahead and experiment a little bit here, maybe walking your hands a little bit forward, creating more space between your hands and your feet. And then you can pedal your feet, maybe sway your hips. And look to the front of your mat, and you can walk, step, jump, tiptoe, however you need to do to bring your feet up by your hands. Exhale and fold here. Think of the crown of your head reaching towards the earth, your tailbone reaching towards the sky. And then on your next inhale, with a straight spine, reverse swan dive, bringing the arms out to the side, bringing them up towards the sky. And as you exhale, bringing the hands down to the heart.